We're starting off here. We have three girls listening to four songs, then talking about which ones they like. And no song is liked by all three girls. And for each pair of girls, there's at least one song out there those two girls like, other girl doesn't like. And we want to count how many different ways this is possible. Now, what we're talking about in this problem, what we're trying to count is the number of ways to make connections between girls and songs. Now, with counting problems about connections, I like to draw pictures. Specifically, I like to draw pictures we call graphs. Put a point for each girl, point for each song, and then we connect the points based on what songs what girls like. Now, we'll start off here by picking a song that the first pair of girls like. So there's four songs over here they can choose from. Let's say they choose this one. So four ways for the first pair to choose. Then we'll move on to the next pair of girls. Say this one and this one. We'll make them red. This pair of girls can't like this song, because then this song will be liked by three girls, by all three girls, and no song is liked by all three girls. So there are three choices for the second pair. And of course, that leaves us just two choices for the final pair. But what do we do about that last song that's sitting there? I mean, this last song, well, it can't be liked by all three girls, but it can be liked by, it could be liked by these two, or these two, or these two up here. That's three options. It could be liked by each one of these girls individually. That's three more options. Or it could be liked by no girls at all. So it looks like there's seven ways, seven things that we can do with this song out here. But if we put a 7 here, well, 4 times 3 times 2 is 24. Multiplying a 7, we get, let's see, 7 times 24, 140 plus 28 is 168. Not one of our choices. Note to the AMC, 168 would have been a really good distractor here. But that's clearly wrong. We can't put a 7 out here. We'll get 168. Not the right answer. Not one of the choices. Should have been, though. What's going wrong? Why can't we just multiply by 7 out here for the number of ways we can connect into that last point? Well, let's take a look at what happens if one of those options is these first two girls likes that last song as well, because these two girls can like two different songs. Now we see the problem with putting a 7 out here. We're going to have a 4 for them choosing their first song, and then we're going to count them grabbing this second song in the last pair. We can do that in the other order. We've got some double counting here. What if they chose this song as their first song that they both liked instead of that one? Got some double counting here. It's going to be kind of a problem. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to split into cases. I'm going to look at one case where we have a setup like this. We have one pair of girls that likes two songs. And then we're going to look separately at what happens if there's no pair of girls that likes two songs. So we'll look at each of these cases just as we did before. We'll draw a picture. Girls, songs. Here are three girls. Here are four songs. And there's one pair that likes two songs. Of course, we have to start off by choosing that pair of girls. There are three pairs to choose from. So we have three ways to choose which pair of girls likes two songs. And then once we've chosen that pair, there are four songs over here, so there are four choose two ways to choose their songs. Now once we've done that, we've got two remaining pairs of girls. Each one has to get a song. So the first pair has two choices. And then, of course, the remaining pair just gets that last song that hasn't been chosen yet. So the remaining pair, that's these two, gets the last song. And now we just multiply this out. 3, 4 choose 2 is 6, 3 times 6 is 18, times 2 is 36. So there are 36 ways the girls can like their songs if there's one pair that likes two songs. Now let's take a look at our other case. Once again, we draw a picture. Girls, songs. Three girls, four songs. We call these pictures graphs. Big, rich area of math called graph theory. It has to do with drawing graphs, points, connections. Here, we have no pair likes two songs. All right, once again, we'll start off with our first pair of girls. They have four choices. And that means our second pair has three choices. And then our third pair has two choices. Now what's going on with that last song? We know this last song can't be liked by two girls, can't be liked by all three girls either. It can be liked by just one girl, or it can be liked by no girls at all. So our final song has four options, and here we have no overcounting because there's no way two girls likes this song. It's either one girl, one of these three girls, or no girls at all. There are four possibilities. So we have 4 times 3 times 2 is 24. Times 4 gives us 96 ways to allocate the girls to the song such that no pair likes two songs. So we got 96 in this case. We add it to the 36 in this case, and we get our answer, 132. And we're done.